Dan, congratulations. Last game against Edisto, you guys get that win. And we had talked about how important it was to you even before the game. Mm-hmm. You're telling me you really wanted to get that, to go into the offseason on a high note. Just finished talking to your quarterback. He said it was big, mm-hmm. big, heading into offseason workouts. Just talk a little bit about it.
It was a great win for us. Edisto is a very physically talented team. Up front, you know, they were very good. You know, we had a lot of trouble, you know, with them on both sides. We basically felt like it was about the fourth most talented team we had played all year as far as physical talents go. But we didn't turn the ball over and we didn't miss tackles. And that's the stuff that held us back all year long. It is a good win going into the offseason now. As you saw, we're getting ready to refurbish our weight room and get into a brand new facility there. So that's going to give our younger guys something to be excited about. And it was nice to come off the field and see the kids smiling a little bit, you know, and I encouraged them to celebrate. You know, we actually, I'll give them credit. They were waiting on me in the same spot with the, you know, same look on their face as they do every Friday night. And I told them, I said, you know, get up, jump up and down, celebrate, have a good time. You know, right. This is good. And so it was a good thing for us. And it was good for me personally. You know, I live in Cordova. So, you know, I'm around all those folks.
Oh, yeah.
It was a good win for our program. You know, that proved to our guys, if we do the little things right, we can play. You know, if we did the little things right.
Starting with your quarterback, who had a fine game, over 200 yards passing. He ran and passed for a touchdown. And you need guys, obviously, they're going to lead. You can't be there to hold their hand all the time in the off season when they need to be working out and that kind of thing. He's the kind of kid, I think, that from what you were telling me, will be that guy. And you have some others that mm-hmm. you feel like can take ownership.
George is a tough kid, and George is a football player, because how many quarterbacks do you know that also play linebacker? Mm-hmm. George is doing a good job as a sophomore. We're going to have some rising seniors this year, Darren Keith, Alex Connor. These are guys that do it the way we want it done. Mm-hmm. They're in the weight room when they're supposed to be. They're showing up here where they're supposed to be. These are football players, and we've got to find more of those. And, you know, we need better leadership out of our guys who aren't afraid to lead because they're afraid of what some of their teammates may say about that. Mm-hmm. If our players have a problem with good leadership, you know, maybe this isn't the sport for them. Maybe that's the mm-hmm. case. I don't know. Mm-hmm. But I'm excited about next year's team. We have, you know, we got some good kids coming back, and we got some high character guys coming back that will, you know, hopefully lead us in the right direction, in a better direction. They're a little bit more team oriented. You know, I think, and we will. That's going to be one of our goals for next year. You know, to be a better team, be a better teammate, and to leave our demons behind.
Yeah.
You know, that have been holding us back.
New chapter.
Hopefully.
New chapter. Well, congrats again, man. I was so happy when I saw him Friday night that y'all had gotten that win.
Thank you.
Feel mighty good.
It has. It's been a lot easier to come to work in the last few days.
And to go to the grocery store
and to go to the grocery
in Cordova.
Store at home, exactly.
All right, Dan. Thanks, man.
All right. Thank you, Rich.